I've seen things people wouldn't believe.
Boss, how are you?
I'm actually quite good.
You look good. Your show has just passed and it was fabulous. I love your pieces.
Thank you.
This is actually one of your dresses and thank you for lending it to me today.
Well, you know, I'm very flattered that...
It's beautiful. I love
who's,
it.
Who's more beautiful, really, you or the dress?
Oh, yeah. Shush. What were your impressions of your show today?
I saw it on the screen, on the TV screen backstage. And the wonderful thing was that I told everyone, like, you're not a model today. You are an actress in a movie and you're playing a part. So I briefed every girl what to do, how to behave. And I told them, like, if you feel it on the inside, you're showing it on
Absolutely.
The outside.
Absolutely, that's beautiful.
And when I was looking at the screen, at the little TV screen, I really, at some point, I forgot that they were showing my clothes. I thought I was looking at a movie. Like, wow, they're so amazing. So beautiful clothes. And then I was like, wait a minute, they're my clothes.
I know, that's the best thing you could actually say yes. about your collection. You forgot they were there,
yes,
basically.
Because it's, to me, like, it's not just about the clothes and the models, etc. It's about everyone working on it. Like, you know, the wonderful team, the lighting, the people backstage.
Absolutely. It's a teamwork, isn't it?
It's totally teamwork.
It is, right? So you've been a creator since a young age, right? You started very, very young. I guess it's almost in your DNA, isn't it?
The thing was, I always knew how to draw.
Okay.
And I was crazy about fairy tales and the magic of the fairy tale. So then I drew princesses and princesses and princesses. But if you do that for years, all of a sudden you become tired of a big ball dress. And then I was like, listen, this is the beginning of the 80s. Women are getting emancipated. Let's put the princess in some pants.
Beautiful.
So, and that's what it started, like one pant became two and a little skirt. And then I'm from a little village in the countryside of Holland.
Right.
And we don't have Vogue.
You don't, right?
And there was no YouTube. So I just figured it out. And then someone asked me, like, oh, wow, you draw so beautifully and wonderful designs. Can you make something for me? So I had my first client when I was 12.
That's beautiful. 12 years old.
And from there, one became two. And
well, congratulations, because today you're really, I could say, a successful designer, and very happy to see your work. What do you think about Arab Fashion Week and you know, the platform of fashion in Dubai?
The platform, like, first, Dubai as a city,
yeah.
The more and more I am here, it feels like the New York of the Middle East. It's very difficult to find someone from Dubai, like New York.
It is, right?
Like, everyone's from
Nobody's
everywhere.
From here, exactly.
And what I see now is that the Arab Fashion Week is a reflection of what the city is.
Wow.
So I see designers from, of course, from Holland, that's me, from Brazil, from the wonderful princess from the United Emirates.
Yeah.
So it's a really different feel from, say, the Western cosmopolitan feel. So that's why it's nice to see that Dubai has its very own entity.
That's great. So you would you come for a second edition if there were a second edition?
Would I think I'm hooked.
Okay, so we'll see you here maybe in the second edition.
Well, yeah, hopefully.
One little thing. Do you have a favorite piece? Because I like to ask that. A favorite piece. Is there one piece that is particularly close to your heart?
Two, actually.
Okay.
One is the Cognac ensemble.
With
like the flames, etc., which is inspired
yes.
by having a glass of brandy mm. by the fireplace.
Wow.
And the light that goes through the glass of brandy. And I saw it and I was like, oh, this is so beautiful. I have to capture that.
Beautiful.
And the other one is a feather dress.
The
black and the colored feather.
Oh,
I made it especially for Dubai Fashion Week.
Oh, really? That's the thing. Did you adjust your collection for Dubai?
Did you have to do any adjustments? And I thought I would do it like, you know, maybe 2 weeks or something.
Right.
And 2 weeks became four, and four became six. And I think that piece has like 500 hours now in it.
You're kidding me.
I know.
But it was worth it.
You should see the atelier.
It was
like,
worth
you know, some chicken had made a fight. So when I go back home and I open the door, it's like,
Well, thank you so much for your time.
It's lovely seeing you. Again,
I love your pieces. And again, thank you for lending me your dress.
You're welcome.
Thank you. Have a great time.
Alla prossima.
Alla prossima.